Welcome to TV station of 易经风水维新 TV. Today is Monday, July 24th, 2017. This is Fiona serving you the news of new religion of the world, Taiwan 维新圣教 of this week. First of all, we're going to take a look at the footage from the 2017 Cross-Strait 鬼谷 Cultural Congress, 云梦 Forum, which took place at 云梦 Mountain in Henan Province of China.
On July the 12th, the Guigu Research Branch of the Chinese Association for Beijing History organized the 2017 Cross-Strait Guigu Cultural Congress Yunmeng Forum in the Guigu Culture Hall of the Yunmeng Mountain 8 Trigam City. The Grandmaster Hu Nianchan Shi, President Yang of the Taiwan Guigu Cultural Academy, and the Taiwanese scholars were invited to participate and exchange knowledge with the scholars from the mainland China.The instructions in the Grandmaster's speech concern the cross-strait peace and the principle that the people on both sides of the strait are one family.
鬼谷先师他所开示的，就是两岸要和平，同是三族，中华文化，中华儿女，啊，心连心，手牵手，共创呢，两岸真和平的开始，整整36年的时间。啊，本人从无到今天，啊，悠悠岁月36年的，啊，一面走过，啊，风风雨雨千锤百炼的，各种的，啊，两岸同胞，啊，这个误解，啊，或是曲解，或是啊一条心。啊，这个都是已经过去了，所以鬼谷先师他开示了，要以鬼谷文化、鬼谷子的智慧、鬼谷文化来促进两岸同胞本是同根同源同祖德，要两岸一家亲。所以啊，我们在这么多年来啊，投资了啊云梦山。这个八卦城，啊，请台湾台商在大陆的台商们一起来为两岸啊三族儿女新桥心里铺上一座桥，就在娓娓道气高的天上世界，啊，我们重新来会友，来会祖灵，所以我们在。这么多年来一直在举办的两岸鬼谷子学术研究会。
Grandmaster also expressed hope that 鬼谷子 can serve as a bright lantern for the peace among people, put ancient wisdom to contemporary use, and enter the hearts of people on both sides of the strait to advance the true cross-strait peace. All scholars participating in the forum shared their wisdom and results of their research on 鬼谷 culture in mutual exchange.The Congress achieved its goals. Weixin News reporting from Yunmeng Mountain.
The merciful Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva once instructed Grandmaster Hu Nianchan Shi that the best place to find a helping hand is at the end of your arm, and the best helping hand is your true self. All the branch temples of Weixin Shenjiao held benediction rituals.For the enlightenment of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva on June 19th of the lunar calendar. The rituals are a way to express our gratitude to the Bodhisattva for her protection. Offerings such as incense, flower, fruit, longevity noodles, longevity peach-shaped bun, and congratulations to the birth of saintly deity and Buddha benediction statement were prepared.Following the rite, the participants recite Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva Sutra in hope that the miraculous religious power could eliminate plague, disasters, famine, and war, and bring world peace.
On July 12th, it just happened to coincide with the day in commemoration of the enlightenment of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva on June 19th in lunar calendar. By piously following the religious chanting rite to chant the scriptures, the benediction rituals were held with incenses, flowers, fruits, birthday peach buns, and birthday noodles to celebrate the enlightenment of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva at Weixin Shenjia branch temples, to pray for not only the safety and prosperity of our country, but all the sentient beings in the neighborhood of branch temples could be safe and sound as well.The foundation of Weixin Shengjiao originated from the Nirmanikaya of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva compassionately saving Grand Master Hunyuan Chanshi's life and instructing Grand Master Hunyuan Chanshi to preach Yi Jin Heart Dharma to help and save people to relieve their tribulations. Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva also asked Wang Chan Lao Tzu Guru to descend to mundane world to make heaven and man joining as one with Grand Master Hunyuan Chanshi.Under the hard working on promoting the wondrous Dharma to the world for more than 30 years, all Weixin Shengjiao virtuous fellows and followers are so grateful to Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva for compassionately blessing people to be safe and sound, to be able to learn the wondrous Dharma for self-cultivation by chanting sutras.On the day in commemoration of the enlightenment of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, all Weixin Shengjiao virtuous fellows gathered at Weixin Shengjiao branch temples to piously attend the benediction rituals, to chant Wang Chan Lao Tzu Profound Sutra and the Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva Universal Gate Sutra, to sincerely thank Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva for compassionately saving people.They also piously pray to Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva for the blessings on the peace, happiness, and prosperity in Taiwan, and the blessings on Grand Master Hunyuan Chanshi in good health, as well as the blessings on all the sentient beings in the neighborhood of branch temples could be safe and sound. The benediction rituals for the enlightenment of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva were successfully completed.Weixin News.
Take a break. We will come back soon. New religion Weixin Shengjiao boasts a variety of social connections.Including community college for Yi Jin education, holding teacher training summer study camp, which introduces Yi Jin into mainstream education, participating in international religious exchanges, and hosting cross-strait academic forums. We are keen in urban planning and providing multiple social services, such as young house survey, consulting service in each branch temple,and campus reconstruction after the 9-1 earthquake. Most significantly, we cross the boundary which stands between religions and participate in important rituals of different religions. With an altruist mind, Weixin Shengjiao assists temples for their construction, reconstruction, and planning by offering feng shui advice. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi guides people to learn Yi Jin feng shui,embrace the boundary of religions and nations, how he influences the people across China and Taiwan, and people around the world can be answered in Weixin feature story, The Practitioner of Yi, Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi. Since 1982, Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi began to apply himself to religious practice,and to the attainment of world peace as his ultimate aim. In more than 30 years, he became an honorable practitioner of Yi who propagated Chinese cultural orthodoxy, Yi Jin Heart Dharma, and Feng Shui to every corner of the world. In the following, we are going to serve you the stories about Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi.Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi was born Zhang Yirui in 1944 in Zhongliao Town, Nantou County. He grew up poor and worked with his family to plow fields and farming till he was 9 years old. Lacking of transportation, he had to walk to school roughly 2 hours every day. even though he was very happy and thought school was a joyful place, because he cherished the rare opportunity of education. After graduating from elementary school, he was admitted into junior high program of Nantou Senior High School. However, on August 7, 1959, a disastrous flood struck Taiwan, flooding Court of Rose. He made switch to Zhongliao branch of Caotun Junior High School and became the first graduate where students need to reclaim lands to help with school construction instead of studying. Then, Grandmaster Hu Yuanchanshi got in Guanghua Vocational High School in Taichung and graduated from the Department of Civil Engineering. After that, he took Army service in Entertainment Battalion that provided programs, services, and entertainment to Air Force's members. This battalion was asked to entertain the troops of armed forces. He brought a trumpet and worked with many stars, both well-known and new. During the mandatory military service period, it was one of the most exciting memories before Grandmaster Hu Yuanchanshi started his preaching career. When he ended his military duty, Grandmaster Hu Yuanchanshi worked for Zhang Dongmo Agent Office. His job included writing legal documents for others and land surveying. He also taught surveying practice at Guanghua Vocational High School. At that time, he believed that in Taiwan, there will be a lot of demand of civil engineering specialists in the future. He had foreseen this picture, so he devoted himself to his career map. In year 1967, Grandmaster Hu Yuanchanshi established Zhongxin Survey, the first survey company of Taiwan. The company's business included urban planning, road development, aerial surveying, and land surveying. With the advanced equipment and responsible attitude, he had an outstanding performance in the field and received favorable feedbacks. In year 1982, what happens that Grandmaster Hu Yuanchanshi decided to give up his successful business and how he became united with venerable ancestor Wang Chan Laozu? Please join our feature story next week. We will tell you more brilliant stories. Branch temples of Weixin Shenjiao, following the instruction of Grandmaster Hu Yuanchanshi, make the day when Wang Chan Laozu golden statue fired into seat their anniversary. Every year on the anniversary, Branch Temple will hold annual benediction and disaster elimination ritual. Following the rites, there will be lotus seeds and chanting masters chanting sutras for the spirits in the Dharma realms, which are ways to pray for peace and safety of the nation and world. By watching the footage of Tainan Branch Temple's annual benediction and disaster elimination ritual on July 14th, we hope you will have a better picture of the culture of Weixin rituals.
Weixin Shenjiao Tainan Branch Temple held its annual ritual on July 14th. Master Zhe Hui from Shanjue Temple was invited to officiate the religious rite. Virtuous fellows also brought golden statue of Wang Chan Laozu, returned to the Tainan Branch Temple, which they venerated at home. All participants piously paid tribute to Wang Chan Laozu, Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva and Buddhas, invited them to descend to the altar. They chanted sutras and spread the blessings of Dharma to thank Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva and Wang Chan Laozu for their compassionate blessings on transit to the spirit and ascend to the pure land. They also prayed to Buddha and Bodhisattvas for the enrichment of wisdom, safety, and happiness. Tainan Branch Temple's anniversary ritual was timed to coincide with the date in commemoration of the enlightenment of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva. They invited eminent monks to officiate the ritual. Before the commencement of the anniversary ritual, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi instructed that they should perform three altars of water repentance sutra, lead Weixin virtuous fellows, underworld and human world, repented from the depths of their heart, seek for their resolution of the grievances, and pray to have a harmonious society. 2 days ago, Tainan Branch Temple gathered volunteers and virtuous fellows to make a complete preparation for succeed this annual ritual. Tainan Branch Temple purchased its location in 2006 in southwest Tainan. Nearby Tainan Branch Temple was Tainan City Government and had many good attractions such like Eternal Golden Castle, Lin Moniang Park, and Anping Fort. Tainan Branch Temple started to build in 2007 and completed in 2009. The Abbot Master Yuan Xing bridged Yi Jing Feng Shui Profound Dharma in Tainan area and turned the Dharma wheel together with Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi for world peace. Weixin News, Tainan.
Take a break. We will come back soon. For this week's education news, Weixin Shenjiao 17th Intensive Yijing Heart Dharma Summer Program for college students takes place at Weixin Shenjiao College starting from this year. Students who are embarking on their new journey in life spend a month here learning the basic ideas of Yi Jing Feng Shui and how to practice it in their daily lives. Now, the students are transmitted to Taipei Shulin Da'an Branch Temple for learning religious rites and manners.
The 17th summer program for college students of Weixin Shenjiao College went to Taipei Da'an Branch Temple and kept learning Yi Jing for 12 days. The summer program for college students for Weixin Shenjiao have been undertaken by Master Yuan De and Master Yuan Dao since many years ago. It is founded for college students so that they can learn more about Yi Jing and Feng Shui during summer vacation. Besides that, the program also planned to invite many praiseworthy friends to come to teach the students some knowledge that we can't learn from books and also open their mind to make them better. Through 16 periods hard working, the summer program has become one of the most popular camps, and it mainly thanks to Master Yuan De and Master Yuan Dao. The program is undertaken by Weixin Shenjiao College this year, and it also plans some days to go to Da'an Branch Temple to learn about the process of ritual, experience the heart of ritual, and cherish the ritual that seems easy but huge. Master Yuan Dao also expected the college students to work hard and never be a nobody.
最重要的一件大事，会影响你们一生的幸福啊！而且你们前途光明就在这一天开始。所以我首先要跟你们讲，进入维新政教来要做什么？主要你很认真的学修，是要来学习当神仙，不是凡夫。
Weixin News at Da'an Branch Temple。
Yi Jing University lecturer Yuan Xie led Yi Jing Feng Shui preaching class to visit branch temples of Weixin Shenjiao for a better understanding of the architectural features and religious culture. Take a look.
Weixin Shenjiao promotes Yi Jing and Heart Dharma education among the general public for learning Yi Jing. Yi Jing is the key to enlighten everyone's inner wisdom.The beneficiary will not only for their family, but also for the whole society. On July 15th, Yi Jing University lecturer Yuan Xie led Yi Jing Feng Shui preaching classes to visit the branch temples. Everybody first arrived at Taichung Branch Temple. Master Yuan Yi introduced the decorations and the origin of Taichung Branch Temple.Master Yuan Yi also encouraged everyone to attend a fundamental class of Yi Jing Feng Shui, which could protect everyone from getting hurt. Next, they traveled to Yi Jing University and introduced the Yang House Feng Shui principle by Master Yuan Quan. Then, Master Yuan Xie led the virtuous pharaohs traveled to Xianfu Temple and led the students to worship Wangchan Lao Zhu and Buddhas.After lunch, tour guide Miss Liu introduced a historical site and the natural world how amazing at Shenfu Temple. The end of the tour, they went to visit the Fengyuan classroom. Master Yuan Ping present a variety of relevant topics with household feng shui principle and how to apply the knowledge to our surrounding at home. Lecturer Yuan Xie introduced the purpose of journey.
让每一位学员能够了解他参加社区弘法这个维新中的团体是什么样的团体，让大家去了解我们的那个远大的那个师父的远大的那个世界和平的这一个观点，然后我们的易经大学将来是要达到世界和平，然后是要养贤蓄才。
维新 News Summary Report。
New Religion of the World, Taiwan 维新圣教 boasts modern and practical 易经风水 culture. 维新 News is dedicated to providing you with the most abundant and diverse news about the development of the 维新 world. Thank you for tuning in today. Please join us on Monday evening at 11:30, Tuesday morning at 11:30 and 4:30 p.m. 王禅老祖 bless you and your family. See you next week.